But a little bit about myself. I am a former gangbanger. I am a former drug user. I've been in lots of crazy, crazy situations. I'm not saying I've done it all, but I've done a lot. And I'm still alive. Lots of times I should have been dead. Lots of times I should be in prison. The Lord saved me. I'm saved by grace. And in any way, I just hope that I can be an inspiration for some of you youth, even some adults. You know what I mean? Inspiration, you know? All we're trying to do is get you to follow Christ. And if we can get you to follow Christ, then the job is done. So amen to that. And let's get into the song, Where Do I Go? Yeah. If you ain't got nowhere to go, you feel like you don't, reach for God. He's there for you, always.
Where do I go from here? Where do I go? Where do I go from here? Where do I go? Where do I go from here? Where do I go? Where do I go from here? I'm going down. I need the Lord on my side, cause I can't seem to get my life right. Yeah, I'm going down. I need the Lord on my side. I'm too weak on my own to win this fight. I'm going down, Lord.
Feeling in my darkest hour. Need a hand from my Lord above to pull me out of the pit before I get devoured. It's now or never, gotta resist temptation. See the fallen angels on a mission, trying to pull me in the belly of the beast where the devil is waiting. But they finna find out that I'm not the one. No, I am not the one. In the name of my Father, Son, I'm gonna embrace the light and I'm gonna fight for you.
Now as I walk for my Lord above, He told me fear no evil, son, cause in God you trust. Where do I go from here? Where do I go? Where do I go from here? Where do I go? Where do I go from here? Where do I go? Where do I go from here? I'm going down. I need the Lord on my side, cause I can't seem to get my life right. And I'm going alive.
What's this? With a gift that's sent from above, been a rider for Christ since way back when, like day one. Been through trial after trial and tribulations, but in the meanwhile, I got my faith and I'm patiently waiting. What motivates me to make it through the day? Let's start with the fact that my Lord and Savior gave His own life for me. And I never take that for granted, that's why I'm loving every minute on this planet. He's giving me and my family, let's make it happen. Little bit of what I test me rapping, I've been given the power, the pen, and I'm ready to put it up under the pedals. I'm headed up into the booth, feel the blessings of the Lord on my side as I'm talking to you. You heard the cracks, I threw it open, you can heal your mind. And I know the temptations are mud, but we need to rise above the devil and let him know enough's enough. Cause in God we trust, so come march with us. Cause all I wanna hear at the end of this life is well done.
This is gonna be the last song of the night. It's my testimony. And before I kinda sing the song, I just wanna share with you kinda my testimony. And kinda like Mike said, you know, I grew up around gang violence and stuff like that. Being, you know, a big boy, everybody wanted me to be on their gang. I'm just saying. I said, being a big boy, everybody always wanted me in their gang.
I would have.
Right? Totally. Anyway, but I grew up with abuse, with never knowing what real love was. And that's kind of what this next song talks about is. This next song is called I'm God's Man. I went from a bad man into God's man. So, all right, let's play it.
It's good.
See, people say you can take the boy out the hood, but you can't take the hood out the boy. Well, Mike, I don't mind.
Yeah, I don't either, brother.
I'm a living testimony. Check it out.
I was born in these streets, raised in these streets, walked in these streets, talked by these streets, lived in these streets, hustled in these streets, rested in these streets, protected by these streets, yea, though I walk through the valley of these streets, I shall not fear these streets, cause I ran these streets, and I paid my dues with borrowed pennies. Now I'm God's man. Oh yeah, I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed. You're God's man. My life has been changed.
stand for what's right, ooh. Won't bow down, though it will cost their life, ooh. Won't back down, but they will fight this fight. It breaks my heart to see these sheep being led to their slaughter. My heart cries out to all the families of these end-time martyrs. Even as I write this song, I'm getting upset. For such a time as this, just know that I have been sent to destroy the works of the enemy. Send help, captives, pretouch are blind and they see. Pray sickness and poverty. Hear my Lord, you can use me. All for your glory, because greater is he who's living in me. We bind the enemy, the name of Christ we raise. Satan is confused when we begin to praise. This battle is the Lord, but Joe is not my strength. Jesus is a victor, Lord, we praise your name. Praising him and lifting him high. He is my everything, he's number one in my life. I try to walk like Christ, talk like Christ, live like Christ, be like Christ. And I don't care what this one may say. You can take my head, I'd rather keep my faith. I try to walk like Christ, talk like Christ, live like Christ, be like Christ.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. All right, we ain't done yet. I mean, you.
But I wanted to talk to you about love tonight. Love. L-O-V-E. Everybody hear me? Okay. So, Father God, I just come before you, Lord, and I thank you for the word, for your word. It's a lamp unto our feet, Lord. I thank you for what you're going to do tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I'm convinced that love, true love, is the answer. I'm convinced that true love is the answer for racism. It's the true answer for everything that's going on with jihad and everything that's going on with the world nowadays, with this generation, with... I'm convinced that love is the answer. Amen. Jesus is the answer because Jesus is love. Right?
Amen.
How many of you are believers of Christ?
Amen.
So how many of you believe that Jesus is love and that love is the answer? That love covers a multitude of sin. It keeps no record of wrongs. It's patient. It's kind. Gentleness, meekness, long suffering. Right? So, I'm convinced that without his love, we would never know his grace. Grace was enough for us, wasn't it? We were talking about grace earlier, and we were saying that grace isn't, that justice is what I deserve. Justice is what I deserve. When I've done something wrong, I deserve to stand before a judge and get sentenced for the full. But grace and mercy is when the judge says, no, I'm going to pardon that. I'm not going to allow you to do so much time for that. Or if you look in scripture where it talks about the parable of the person that owed the much, more he owed his creditor. And if you understand that the year of Jubilee, every 7 years, that they would be totally debt-free at the end of that, the creditor would forgive that debt every 7 years. That's Jewish principles. But I'm here to let you know that if it wasn't for love, if it wasn't for grace, if it wasn't for mercy, I wouldn't be standing here. Neither would Anon. None of us would, right? Because justice says that I should go to hell. Justice says that I deserve everything that I've ever done wrong. Justice says I deserve what I reap. Because I've sowed wrong, right? But grace looks past all that. Grace looks past all the wrong, looks past everything. And grace looks at the heart of the person. The word of God says that he's found by those that seek him when they seek him with all their heart, right? I'm convinced that love is the answer. God's love towards us is amazing. What are some scriptures that you're reminded of his love towards us? John 3:16, right? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth on him should not perish but have everlasting life, right? That's God's love to us. I think there's three things. There's three steps in this love process. Second step is our love to God. He loved us while we were yet sinners. There's also we have to love the Lord our God with all our heart, all our soul, all our mind, all of our strength, right? So is love, did God create us to be robots and just say, bam, you're going to love me and that's the way it is? No, we make a conscious decision to love him. That's followed by a lifestyle. That's how we love the Lord, is by our life, by our lifestyle. There's a song that says, I just keep falling in love with him over and over again, over and over again. You know, it's just the old song, but it reminds me of that. And then lastly, ooh, that was close. See, that was grace. He almost had a concussion right there, but grace said,
stop.
The third thing is that love that God has shown us, that we are supposed to show back to him, is supposed to radiate to everyone around us. Every relationship. I wouldn't test that grace too much more, brother. I'm just saying. Perfect. That's what I need. Thank you, Lord. See? And then the grace was perfected. Nice. I like that. That's good. And there's some more grace. Anyway, the point is that how are we going to win the world? How are we going to win our community? How are we going to win our family? By love. Love keeps no records of wrongs. It doesn't envy. It's not boastful. It's not proud. Love never fails. And guess what love requires? Love requires us to even tell the truth. Love doesn't mean I agree with everything that you do. Love, God so loved us so much that he didn't agree with everything that we did or that we've done. He didn't agree with everything that he didn't step into agreement with our sin. So he loves us so much to tell us the truth. And I think it's just a way of delivering the truth. I think we've got to do it. This is my opinion right here. This is not thus saith the Lord. This is Joshua saying this. That if we want to impact the world, we've got to show love. We can't be judgmental. We can't be talking about people because they got tattoos all over their arms saying, you're going to go to hell. You're going to burn. You're going to do this. Man looks on the outward appearance, but God looks on the heart. You don't know the person that you're in contact with every day. You don't know whether the person that you're judging wrong, whether they're anointed by God and chosen by God. Because I guarantee you one thing, every single one of us were created with purpose and destiny. I think it's up to us to show the love of Christ that he showed to us and convey it to everyone else. So we need to pull that out of people. We need to pull it out of them by encouraging them, telling them when they're wrong, but praying with them and saying, I'm not going to judge you in your wrongness. I'm just here to help you and get out of that. I'm convinced that love is the answer. Love is the answer for everything. And I'm not going to sit here and sing that song, love, love, love is the answer. I'm just saying that for God so loved us that we need to love him back. And when we love him back, it'll be displayed throughout this world. So, Father, I just love you. I thank you that you loved us first. We didn't love you first. You loved us first.
I thank you for the work of the cross that you did. I thank you for dying a cruel death. Lord, you went through everything that we've ever had to face. You went through humiliation. You've been beaten. You've been mocked. You've been lied on. You've been talked about. You've been defamed. You've been embarrassed to the point of humiliation. Naked, dying on a cross is how you left this earth. And you did it all in obedience to your Father, Lord. You loved us so much that you gave us your Son, Lord. I thank you for that blood. That blood is enough, was enough, and is still enough for this day and age, Lord. I thank you for your blood, Lord. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
If there's anybody that needs any prayer, if maybe you've fallen away from what your commitment or dedication to Christ, or anybody that doesn't know the Lord, just want to make this moment available for you. We don't have to do a big song and dance over it. We can just get real right now with a real God at a real moment for a real time right now. If you need prayer, I don't care what it's for. I'm not just talking to the unsaved, the saved. You need any prayer for anything. I'm sure that I can get Brother from Calvary Chapel, Levi, if Levi would make himself available, and maybe a couple ladies from the church to pray. We just want to believe. We want to meet God right now with all of our needs and give them to him. So if you have prayer for anything, please come on up.
Come on up.
Please come on up.
Be shy.
And turn that up.
How he loves us so.